The views and opinions expressed on Detroit Wants to Know with Steve Hood are not those of WADL TV 38 or Adele Broadcasting Corporation.
Detroit Wants to Know is brought to you by 313 Justice, free legal advice.
People moving out, people moving in. Why? Because of the color of the skin.
Run, 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 but you sure can't hide.
Well, nobody's interested in learning but the teacher. Segregation, determination, demonstration, integration, aggravation, humiliation, obligation to my nation.
Good morning. Welcome to Detroit Wants to Know. You're watching TV 38 WADL. Ladies and gentlemen, it is April 15th. The city of Detroit is over $12 billion in debt, not including interest. It can't pay its vendors on time. And wouldn't have made payroll had the city not just gone into debt for $137 million for 20 years. I'm confused, ladies and gentlemen. I need to know what to do to get out of this. So I've called my good friend Ken Gross, who does this for normal people that have trouble. Ken, in your AWF position, tell me, how would you fix the city of Detroit?
It's not an easy problem, but you've got to kind of look at it like any type of a business or an individual. You've got to make it so that it can cash flow in a positive way. Mm-hmm. Right now, I mean, the city of Detroit doesn't have the latitude to operate at deficits, same thing as the state. Only our federal government can do that. Mm-hmm. So what you have to do is you have to find a way, no matter what happens, you have to cut costs, you have to cut expense, so that whatever revenue you have coming in, you can make payroll. If a client comes into us and they're operating a business and they're bleeding and they don't have enough money to make payroll in 2 weeks, what am I going to do? I have two choices. I either tell them go out of business, or we cut all expense that has to be cut so that the business can continue to run. Now, in the city of Detroit's case, or like a large business, you need to sometimes be able to break contracts and intervene so that you can get yourself into a cash flow position. So that means, how do you break contracts? In the American system, you can do it one of two ways, through the bankruptcy court, or in this case, with regard to the state, it's either the consent order or a financial manager. You have to have the power and authority to get out from obligations so that you can start fresh. That's what GM did. Mm-hmm. That's what Chrysler did.
So if this were a family walking into Thav, Gross, Steinweg, Bennett et al., what would you tell them? It's like they just walked in. Okay, we can't pay our bills. We can barely eat, but we have this much money coming in. How would you restructure it?
It depends. If it's a family coming in on an individual basis, you've got to look at what income they have coming in. And then in that case, we've got recourse. We can file a Chapter 7 bankruptcy. We could put them into a Chapter 13 bankruptcy. If they have too much income, sometimes you don't qualify to make a bankruptcy work for you. Let's say you're making $8,000, $9,000 a month, but you're hopelessly buried in debt with, you know, $100,000 of credit card debt. Mm-hmm. You're probably not a good bankruptcy candidate at that point, but we can do other things. We can restructure and stop paying the credit card debt. Mm-hmm. You got to stop paying unessential things. When you're in crisis, you have to dig deep down and you have to make the move that's going to survive. And that means don't pay the credit cards. You don't pay the hospital bill that is outstanding there, because you have to prioritize. First thing you have to do, food on the table. If you need transportation, you got to continue to make your car payment. You need fuel, and you got to pay rent. Everything else is secondary, and then we deal with those problems next. Too many older people come into my office, elderly people, where they've raided their 401ks and their IRAs in order to make mortgage payments on houses that are hopelessly underwater and to pay credit card payments, because the people at the credit card companies call you four times a day harassing you for payment. You should never take your retirement money to pay those kind of bills.
Really? Wow.
Critical.
So translate that back to the city of Detroit.
City of Detroit's got to be able to make payroll. They've got to figure out a way in order to pay their bills. They've got to consolidate their departments. I mean, I don't want to profess to be a wizard as to analyzing what the city's issues are. But in any type of an organization, you've got to trim expense, you've got to consolidate, you've got to look at what Ford did. Look at, you know, how they laid off employees, they cut white collar, they cut blue collar, they cut everywhere, and all of a sudden everyone was working twice as hard as they used to, but they did it until they started making money again. City of Detroit's got to consolidate way down, do what they have to do in order to be able to have the essential services. And what are they? They got to be able to pay their people, and they need security. Because people, if people don't feel secure in the city, people are not going to come back. Look at TechTown. TechTown is phenomenal because it's got energy and it's life and it's attracting people, but you got to stay on that type of a direction.
Okay, and it's secure. Ladies and gentlemen, when we come back, we're going to talk about last-minute tax filing tips. You know, today is the 15th. You know, after this show, you should be going to the post office.
The future of healthcare is taking shape right near you. It's DMC Cardio Team One doctors working with the world's smallest heart pump. It's patient smart rooms that communicate through smart technology. It's electronic medical records so DMC specialists and your personal doctors work together so care is centered around you. DMC's $850 million investment is coming to life, but much of the future is already here. DMC, for 150 years, always there.
Looking for best price and best selection?
Avis Ford!
Sweetheart deal!
These aren't just words at Avis Ford. We need you to truly love everything about buying your new car. That's because what makes it a sweetheart deal is you choose exactly what you want from hundreds of cars, and then you get it at the best rock bottom price. You'll love your price and selection. You'll love how you feel. You'll love your Avis Ford. Shop online at avisford.com or stop in at 12 Mile and Telegraph. Call 1-800-SHOP-FORD.
What is it about a blue sky? A sunset? This smile. What do these moments all hold in common? There is no fear, no worry. It's a feeling unlike any other. For a moment, we're all okay. And then just like that, it's gone. But we can find our way back together. Welcome to peace. Welcome to HAP.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. You're watching TV 38 WADL. It's April 15th. It's tax day. And I'm back with my AWF. That's authoritative white figure, Ken Gross. Ken.
I finally have a title.
You have a title now. Ken, tell me this. It's April 15th. People should, after this show, be leaving to file their taxes, or their taxes already should have been filed. What do they do?
Well, two things. One is to get a little bit of relief this year. You don't have to actually file that return until April 17th because it's Armistice Day on Monday the 16th. But you need, the first thing you need to know is you have to file the return. We see so many people come into our office with tax problems and they have not filed their returns, and the reason why they don't file is because they don't have the money to pay the tax. Mm-hmm. That's a separate issue. If you don't file the return, you get hit with a 25% penalty, 5% a month for 5 months,
ooh,
over and above the penalties for not paying. So no matter what happens, you need to file that return. If you're on the cusp and you're not sure, first of all, you can file an extension. File the extension by the 17th, that buys you to October 15th to file the return. It doesn't delay the obligation to make the payments. And the other thing is you should see a good tax professional to make sure you're getting all the deductions you're allowed to. Are you taking your mortgage interest? Have you taken the charitable deduction to the extent that you're allowed to? Are there any child care credits available to you? You need to make sure that you take care of your homework.
Okay.
And you're not out of time yet. If you haven't done your homework yet, today, April 15th, go to a tax preparer, get an extension filed, and then file the return.
Okay, now the extension, does that interest accrue during the extension?
Interest still accrues. Your actual obligation is to have your tax paid in full by April 15th. However, by filing the extension, you're not going to get hit with penalties for failing to file the return. Those are separate penalties.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Ken, we had a discussion last week, and it was about your daughter. All right, now you're a suburbanite.
I am.
Happy suburbanite.
Apparently I'm an AWF, too.
You're an AWF, happy suburbanite. Are you bullish on Detroit?
I am bullish on Detroit, and I think it's about the first time in the last decade that I felt that way. And one of the things is, you know, my daughter's 24. She graduated with a teaching degree, and she's out in the marketplace teaching now and looking for other jobs. But she's part of a community of young people that are really interested and excited about the city. And they're moving back into the city, looking for into the TechTown area, right around here. It's exciting, and it's kind of unheard of. Mm-hmm. If you go back 5 years ago, where if you're sitting out in the suburbs, you know, the notion of your children moving back to the city was never something discussed. It says there's a future. And for a long time, there wasn't. It's Detroit needs to change to be like other cities, like Chicago, mm-hmm. like Cleveland, and New York's separate. But it's got, it has to, people just, they've got to get beyond the racial divides that have plagued this city for so many years, mm-hmm. and get down there where there's action. There's no better place right now in the summertime than Detroit. Mm-hmm. We got the Tigers. We've got so many things going on downtown. So yeah, I'm bullish on Detroit. I'm excited. They still need to address some things. They've got to get their finances in order, mm-hmm. and they've got to make people feel secure. That's mm-hmm. a big issue. That's a big issue to my wife. Mm-hmm. She does. You know, she's worried about my daughter coming downtown.
She's
worried about security.
She's moving downtown, but there are still two Detroits. There's a Detroit that is downtown, bounded by the river, I-75, the Lodge in Milwaukee, where we're sitting right now. And then there's the areas that are outside of it, which are a little bit less hospitable. I'm glad your daughter's moving in. I'm glad she's going to help increase the tax base in downtown Detroit. And I'm glad you, as a true suburbanite, you know, are open to the fact of Detroit coming back. All right?
There's nothing more fun than having a city.
There's nothing more fun than having a city, and there's nothing more fun than Detroit in the summer. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back.
Facing foreclosure, buried in debt, tax problems, underwater in your home, you are in a crisis. Thav Gross is your solution.
I was thinking about bankruptcy, but I didn't understand what that meant.
You need to look at the big picture. That's what we do. We develop a plan that's right for you. As it turned out,
bankruptcy was right for me.
And now, you're debt-free.
They saved me.
Call Thav Gross, 888-235-HELP.
WADL, your 9 o'clock news station where weather is first. Meteorologist Eric Garlick has your local forecast before anyone else. Mackenzie Henderson keeps you up to date with your local and national news at 9. And for your global news at 9, check out Mike Mickle on WADL. Right here on Detroit's real primetime news station, where news and weather are first. Don't wait for the other guys when you can get it first. Right here at 9 on WADL.
I was the one in my family who always listened. I like talking to people. Growing up, if anyone had a problem, they always came to me. And I think that's why I took this job at HAP as personal service coordinator. I've really found my calling here. I'm a professional problem solver, a human aspirin. And if you call HAP and talk to me, I'll listen.
Introducing Personal Alliance from HAP.
Detroit Wants to Know is sponsored in part by the Associated Food and Petroleum Dealers. AFPD, the voice of the independent retailer.
Detroit Wants to Know is Detroit Television's most energetic and engaging half hour. If you and your company would like to advertise to Detroit Wants to Know's ever-growing audience, send an email to sales@stevehooddetroit.com. Don't miss your chance to touch thousands of Metro Detroiters each week.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. We're here at TechTown. Ladies and gentlemen, we've talked about the economic engine. That is CompuWare. That is Dan Gilbert's companies, Quicken Loans. That is Blue Cross. That is GM. We've talked about TechTown being an economic engine. But there's another economic engine that has been in Detroit for over 100 years, and that is Wayne State University. You aren't going to believe what Wayne State University has done. Ned Staebler, welcome to the show. How are you today?
I'm doing very well, sir. Thanks
Head
for
of
having me.
Director of Economic Development for Wayne State.
Vice President for Economic
Vice
Development.
Vice President for Economic Development.
Got a promotion,
Just got a promotion. Thank you very much. How much economic impact have you had in the last 10 years in this area?
Well, Wayne State is a huge driver for growth in Midtown and really for the city, and actually the whole region. And in the last 10 years, you've seen it in everything from the real estate development that we've done to the on-campus development. So 10 years ago, we didn't have any students living on campus. We were basically a commuter school. Today there's 3,000, and there's a couple thousand more that live in the neighborhoods. So you look at that, that's an extra 20% density into the Midtown District. And density really is one of the key metrics we're looking to drive as we try to revitalize our part of the city.
I've seen some of your spinoffs. You built a building right there just north of the Whitney. You built a bit, well, you worked with a developer to build a building there, but you've got a Big B Coffee there, you've got a Starters there, a
Radio Shack. A bank.
Utrecht.
Art supply store.
You've got all that. So you've got all that commerce going in there with that building. Another one of your apartment buildings right by Wayne State with the gold shiny windows actually holds PBS is inside of there.
Sure. Yeah, that's been a part of our model for about 10 years now, is that when we're going to build things or work with private developers, like in the Studio One development, to build them, we want to make sure that they're friendly to the neighborhood. We don't want to just build a typical inward-looking university building. We want to make sure there's retail and walkability, and that it has the feel of a neighborhood that, you know, with a restaurant or something, a coffee shop, some place where people might come together and meet and do more than just go to class or go to or live.
Okay. Tell us, what's on the horizon for Wayne State in terms of new development?
Absolutely. So between us, Henry Ford, and DMC, we own about 40% of the undeveloped land in Midtown, and I plan on changing
40%
that.
40% of it?
Yeah. Absolutely.
Wow.
And if you look at the build environment, it's even more. I mean, we have 100 plus buildings in the neighborhood. So we're a pretty big landlord, but we use most of it ourselves as well. So my goal is to develop some of those parcels. So we're looking at some of the key areas. You know, you talked about before we were on the break, talking about the Woodward and Warren Avenue, and everyone in town has seen that corner and known that we've cleared it off. So we're looking right now at our options there, because we think that's one of the prime pieces of real estate, right across the street from the DIA, right across the street from our campus, and right on Woodward, which is obviously a pretty visible place in the city.
Okay, do you think your economic development will help you attract more students?
Absolutely, absolutely. We look at us as Wayne State is Detroit, and Detroit is Wayne State. So goes Detroit, so goes Wayne State. So it's in our best interest. It's a necessity for us to be working on improving our neighborhood at all times. Because if we can't attract students, if we can't attract faculty, if we can't attract researchers, we're not going to be successful as a university. I mean, we're a top-tier research university right now, the Carnegie top classification in the country. If we can't keep attracting the top talent, we won't be able to maintain that rating. So we're working very hard from that perspective.
Okay. One more question, real quick. In terms of restaurants and all that, are you actively seeking restaurants to come in here? What are you doing? I see you see that corner where you have a Subway standing out on its own.
Sure.
What's going on here?
So I personally don't spend my time out with the restaurants all that much, but if anybody out there's got a restaurant and they're interested in moving into Midtown, give me a call. We usually work with Midtown Detroit Inc. and Sue Mosey.
Okay.
She knows everybody in town. She knows every landlord and developer. She develops some properties herself and knows what space is available and can help find people the right kind of space. Because every space isn't necessarily suitable for a restaurant. Maybe doesn't have the right venting for a kitchen or enough size to put in the right amount of tables. So certainly some of our properties have restaurants, but we tend to work with Sue on finding the right tenant mix.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back with more Detroit Wants to Know.
The future of healthcare is taking shape right near you. It's DMC Cardio Team One doctors working with the world's smallest heart pump. It's patient smart rooms that communicate through smart technology. It's electronic medical records, so DMC specialists and your personal doctors work together, so care is centered around you. DMC's $850 million investment is coming to life, but much of the future is already here. DMC, for 150 years, always there.
Looking for best price and best selection?
Avis Ford!
Sweetheart deal!
These aren't just words at Avis Ford. We need you to truly love everything about buying your new car. That's because what makes it a sweetheart deal is you choose exactly what you want from hundreds of cars, and then you get it at the best rock bottom price. You'll love your price and selection. You'll love how you feel. You'll love your Avis Ford. Shop online at avisford.com or stop in at 12 Mile and Telegraph. Call 1-800-SHOP-FORD.
What is it about a blue sky that can instantly make us happy? Is it the endless blue or the days we spend under it? What is it about a sunset, the way it marks the end of another day, or the people we spend that moment with? And what is it about this smile that so fills us with hope? For brief moments at a time, we hold the sensation of peace in our hands. But then we all wake up. We live our lives day to day searching for that elusive sense of peace, for the simple protection of a hug, wondering, am I doing the best for myself and my family? Am I keeping them safe? We invite you to come inside. Ask us a question. We'll figure things out together. Welcome to peace. Welcome to HAP.
Get all the news and information you need in prime time. WADL TV 38 News at 9. Join Mackenzie Henderson and Eric Garlick for all the important news, sports, and weather that impacts you. News at 9. All the news and information you need.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. You're watching TV 38, and I'm sitting here with Ned Staebler, Vice President of Economic Development for Wayne State University. We're talking to the other economic development engine. Ned, when we went to break, you were talking about Wayne State being open for business. Mm-hmm. How do you do business with Wayne State? You were mentioning it's here in TechTown. You actually have a thing here?
Absolutely. So, you know, traditionally, it's hard to connect to a university. You know, mm-hmm. it's a big thing. You don't know, what do you call 1-800-WAYNE-STATE? And you might not get a call back. So we've created something we call the front door. And the front door is a single point of entry for somebody who wants to hire students. You want to do research, you want to do a clinical trial, you want to rent out the football field. You can call our front door at 888-WSU-DOOR, and they'll be able to connect you. And we have a 48-hour service guarantee. They'll be back to you within 48 hours with the right resource for you within the university.
Okay. Tell us about Live Midtown.
Yeah, sure. Live Midtown is a great program. This is our residential incentive. This is to try to get our employees, and more of our employees, to live in the neighborhood. And we do it in conjunction with the Detroit Medical Center and with Henry Ford Health Systems. Mm-hmm. The foundation community has helped support it, so for every dollar we put in, they've been putting in a dollar as well, which has been very helpful. Mm-hmm. But last year, more than 200 new residents from the three institutions moved into Midtown, and we just extended it for 4 more years. So total, hopefully, at least 1,000 people will move back into the neighborhood, and that adds another 10-15% density right there. But we give them an incentive to rent a place, to buy a place, or even to fix up their existing place if they're already here.
What are the size of the incentives?
To buy a place, you can get up to $20,000. To rent, it's, I think, $2,500, something
for
like that.
For a month or per year?
For a year.
$2,500
per year. $2,500 is pretty
nice. But that still helps.
To pay you a couple months of your rent, at least, yeah.
Okay, what other partnerships do you guys have?
So we partner not only with Henry Ford and DMC, the other big sort of anchors up in Midtown, but also with the folks downtown. So we're working with Blue Cross and Quicken and CompuWare and a lot of the companies mm-hmm. You were talking about and the Rock mm-hmm. folks and Dan mm-hmm. Gilbert's team on everything from getting our employees together more to doing community service together. We have a meeting coming up, I think, end of next week to talk about creating a bike sharing program. For the city, where you can
bike sharing.
You can pick up a bike in Midtown, ride it downtown, leave it in a place down there, and you know, all for a small annual fee kind of thing, or maybe a daily rental, depending mm-hmm. on the model that we come up with.
But okay, are you involved with public safety at all since you're doing all the development?
Absolutely, absolutely.
Tell me about that.
You
I mean, because this is one of the safest areas in Detroit.
I'm glad you said that. I think a lot mm-hmm. of people sometimes think that we have that bad rap out in the suburbs. People say, mm-hmm. I don't want to go to Wayne State, it's not safe. You're actually safer on our campus than you are in Ann Arbor or East Lansing or Birmingham or Troy. Crime in Midtown is down 40% in the last 3 years. And
Wait. Crime in Detroit is up. Crime in Midtown is down.
Crime in Detroit is actually down a touch in the last 3 years.
Watch your statistics.
It is.
Anyway, crime is up, but crime is down here. That's all we care about.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Well, I won't argue with you on the Detroit stuff, crime is down 40% in Midtown in the last 3 years. We have a police force, the Wayne State Police Force, of 54 officers, fully deputized. So if they give you a speeding ticket, pay the speeding ticket, because they'll send you a summons in the mail.
Everybody
if you don't.
Knows the Wayne State Police don't play. They know they don't play.
They absolutely
don't. It's such a small area to patrol, they're right on you.
They do. And that, you know, we actually do sort of the greater Midtown area now. Mm-hmm. We partner with the Detroit Police Department and the Wayne County Sheriffs and some of those folks to make sure that we're coordinating our coverage. But we use a statistical method of mapping out where the crimes are occurring mm-hmm. and trying to stop them. And as a result, we've had some really good success in doing that. And it's a model that they're trying to replicate now downtown, and, mm-hmm. and we're working with DPD on getting it out in other places in the city.
Because this
too.
Is a real walking community here. It's beautiful.
Absolutely. That's our goal. Like I said before, when we build anything, we want to make sure that we're building walkable urbanism, the right kind of place.
Walkable urbanism.
Exactly. That's a nice buzzword, isn't
that
it?
That is a nice
yeah,
buzzword.
Yeah, it basically means you can walk around. You don't have to have a car to get places. Mm-hmm. In some places, you're discouraged from having a car. It'd be better, you know, to walk there and not have to find extra parking spaces and all that. But you can use that outdoor space to have an outdoor coffee shop or cafe for your restaurant, mm-hmm. or maybe a food truck or something instead of three parking spaces.
Speaking of food trucks, are you mm-hmm. ever going to do like they do out in Seattle, Washington, and actually have a parking lot just of food trucks?
It's interesting.
Oh,
I've seen it. So we've got one on campus now that's there a few days a week.
You got one food truck.
El Guapo is the only one that I think that was licensed last I saw. Is on our campus a few days a week now.
Three Amigos, El Guapo. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Sorry, it's Three Amigos, El Guapo.
No, it's Three Amigos was the movie, but go ahead.
Oh, yeah, sure. So we're actually talking about exploring that concept just across the street from here. Mm-hmm. On a lot that we've got over there.
I think that's the coolest thing.
Yeah.
Ned, I want to thank you for coming down and introducing us to that other economic engine. When we come back, it's time to get up and enjoy Detroit. Thank you.
Get up and enjoy Detroit is sponsored by the Wellness Plan Medical Centers with three locations to serve you. 2888 West Grand Boulevard, Detroit, 4909 East Outer Drive, Detroit, 21040 Greenfield Oak Park. Live and be well.
It's time to get up and enjoy Detroit with Brittney Mabry. It's April 15th.
Thanks, Steve. One reason I really enjoy doing Get Up and Enjoy Detroit is because I get a chance to show you just how culturally diverse Detroit has become. The Detroit Opera House is here to remind us of just that. They are hosting Pearl Fishers. It is the three-act opera. It will be here April 14th through the 22nd. If you are interested in the story of friendship, loyalty, and forbidden love told in French, tickets start at just $29. I think that's going to be a very good tale and some things that will bring something for the city to see. Now, if light shows flick your switch, I thought that was a pretty good joke.
I like that. Light shows do flick my switch.
Okay, then I have a good place for you to see something amazing. Multimedia art pioneers are showing Joshua White and Gary Painter have put together a spectacular event just for the museum itself. This 22,000 fair square foot display will be on display until April 29th. Admission is just $5. Once again, this will be at the Detroit Center for Contemporary Arts. I do believe.
Really? That's going to be a great show.
A good show.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, if you guys are interested in this, please visit us at steveputdetroit.com for more information.
Brittney, that sounds fun. It's tax day. Have you done your taxes?
I've done my taxes.
Okay. You've done your taxes.
Yes.
I've done mine, too. No extension this year.
No extension filed and done.
I'm so proud of myself.
Yes.
I'm so proud of myself. There are a lot of people that go to these little tax stores and they get it done like in January and February, but yeah. I'm not that quick.
Well, I do mine myself.
You do your own taxes?
I do my own taxes.
That's dangerous.
Yeah.
You can catch us at Detroit Wants to Know at steveputdetroit.com or at Detroit Wants to Know on Twitter or our Detroit Wants to Know page on Facebook. Brittney, I want you to have a great week.
I want you.
It's more than two computers.